Hey guys, this is Aaron. I'm going to take a look at a process today that's going to help you take your models to the next level. I have a model of a restaurant here, and you can see I got some photo textures on there, some bricks, some concrete up there, some beautiful little plants in front. It's a good looking model, but there's something missing, and I think you can look at it and pretty easily tell that there's an issue with the glass right now. Right now I have the default material, just that white on there. It's not great looking glass. So one of the options, something that a lot of people do, nothing wrong with this, is to go to the glass and mirrors section and choose one of these transparent materials and paint that in as glass. This works. There's nothing wrong with this. This is a great way to get indicate that it is glass, but that kind of pale blue tint on there makes it look like I have some kind of, blue plastic instead of glass. So I want to figure a way to take that kind of to the next level. I'm going to undo that. I'm going to put my white back in. And what I'm going to do is go up to File, and I'm going to import a new material. So I'm going to import, I have an image of a sunrise, and I'm going to import that as a texture. I'm going to go ahead and use this first pane of glass as my point that I'm going to import it on. I'm going to scale it up. I don't really care how big I scale it, because the next thing I'm going to do is reposition it, so I'm just going to get it in there somehow. Doesn't really matter how right now. All right, so now that that's brought in, I can right click, click texture, and now I'll do my positioning. So I can do a couple things here. One thing I want to do for sure is get it big enough so it drags across the entire front of the building. This is not a tiling texture, obviously, so I want to get it big enough so that it doesn't repeat. It would be an awkward texture if I had multiple suns in the same view. And the other thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag it down so that the horizon reflects across my windows like that. That looks pretty good. I can hit enter. And now what I can do is I can sample my paint bucket and paint that into all the panes. And that's a pretty good look. Right now that looks okay. That looks better than the white did for sure. But I didn't get a transparency on there, so I can't see into the building. So again, to take this a little bit further, if I go home right now, I can see I have that sunrise is now a texture. If I pick on it and I come over here and I change my opacity down to say like 50%, I've actually created a new texture. So if I take that texture and paint that onto the first pane and see right away, look at that, I can see I have some trees there from the image, but I can also see inside of the building. So right now if I right click, texture, position, same process I went through before, get it scaled up properly, and then drag it down, stretch it out a little bit more, so there we go, that looks pretty good. Enter. And now I'll use my paint bucket tool to sample and paste that across all the windows. And now I have kind of the next level. There I have transparency, I can see into the building, but at the same time, I have this landscape and sun reflecting onto the glass. So kind of a neat way to, it's not a real reflection, of course, so as I move this around, the sun stays in the same position, but if I get a nice view, I want to look inside the building and see the table, see that sort of thing, I can do that and actually keep that reflection on the outside of the glass. So, little tool to take your models to the next level. Thank you.